Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Sandor here. Thanks for joining me for another palm video or garden video. So today I'm going to be talking about my Trachycarpus fortunei, the Chinese windmill palm. So it's been just a little over a year since I got this guy. I got it from Niagara Tropics here from a local distributor in southern Ontario. The guy who runs it is Dan Richard. I'll leave a link down to his page on the bottom there in the description for you guys. If any of you guys in Ontario are interested getting some palms for your gardens next year, then he's the guy to go to. So, great guy. Anyways, yeah, so it's been about a year since I got this guy. And I just wanted to do an update. Before I do that, I just wanted to say it is blazing hot. It is very hot. Let's check the temperature out. It is 35 Celsius and 64% humidity. So it's not only hot, it's humid. And not sure of the dew point. I'd have to check that out later, but you can feel it. It's very sticky. And with that humidex, it's probably well over 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So yeah, we're definitely feeling it, but I'm not complaining because here in Southern Ontario, or Canada in general, we get cold winters, guys. So when we get weather like this, at least I enjoy it and I take advantage of it and I don't complain. So for a lot of you older folk, I get it. And people with respiratory ailments and stuff like that, I get it. Stay indoors and stay safe and stay out of this heat. But I really enjoy it. So anyways, back to the Trachycarpus. So yeah, it's been just a little over a year, like I said, a couple of times, and it's doing well. So basically what you're looking at here is a transplant, field grown transplant palm from northern Florida. So from what I know is that this palm the first year doesn't really do much. So I got a couple of fronds out of it last year, I think four, maybe five. And this year I've gotten it the same amount, and summer is just starting. So for reference here, I did mark it right there. That was a week ago, just before I went to Montreal. It's grown about 4 inches, which is crazy. So it's also liking this heat, which is good. And I do water these. First year, anytime you guys get a new palm, make sure you water it consistently, depending on how much rain you get. But I was watering this guy probably, I'd say, five times a week, and a good soaking. So and this year I kind of cut back. I do it every 2 or 3 days, but I give it a good soaking. And actually with the seed, I did water it the last 2 days. I watered it twice, so I'll probably give it another water along with the camera ops here. But it's been so hot that they actually don't mind it. So more water the better is for the palms. So yeah, so first year you're not going to see much growth from what I know. Second year you do see a little more, like I am now, and then third year is when you really start seeing these guys take off. And that's just reference to the Trachycarpus. I'm not talking about other palms. Every palm reacts differently to transplant. Some absolutely do not like it and will not survive, or if they do survive, it's a small chance. And there's procedures you have to go through to do that. So I'm not going to get into all that, but Trachycarpus don't mind it, but they will experience shock for a couple of years. And just for reference here, this Trachycarpus tequila I planted a few weeks back, you guys can check out that video, is actually growing pretty quick. This frond just blew up right away. Another spear pushing out. From what I know, I wouldn't be surprised if this Trachycarpus tequila catches up to this guy in a couple of years. It's quite possible. Potted Trachycarpus seem to really do well, as opposed to uprooted field growns. They grow well, but the speed is not comparable to a potted transplant like this tequila. So time will tell. I have a couple more there that were potted too, so we'll definitely see how they progress next year. This time hopefully you guys can see the reference or the comparison as opposed to this year, and see how much this guy's caught up. But I wouldn't be surprised if this guy and a couple of my other Trachycarpus there catch up to this guy in no time. So if I can keep it alive, we had one of the coldest winters here in Southern Ontario, and I'm actually surprised I was able to keep this guy alive with my protection. We had temperatures below minus 25 Celsius. So yeah, that's cold. So I'm happy I was able to keep this guy alive with some of the coldest temperatures in the last decade. So I must be doing something right. And there's a lot of great channels that I watch out there to help me out and let me know what I'm doing. So hopefully I can help you guys out too. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them. And if you guys are interested in growing palms in colder climates, yeah, leave me questions. Hopefully I can answer them for you guys and help you out. I'm kind of new to this too. I only grew smaller tropicals before, and so this is all new to me too, and it's definitely a learning experience. So thanks again, guys, for watching. And if you guys are in southeast, northeast, or central states, parts of United States, I know, are getting even hotter temperatures in here. So whatever you guys are doing, stay cool. And if you're out, drink a lot of fluids and stay safe, guys. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it. Take care. Cheers.